your ways may be known on earth, your salvation among nations. May the people praise you, O God. May all the people praise you. May the nations be glad and sing for joy. May you rule the people justly and guide the nations of the earth. May the peoples praise you, O God. May all the peoples praise you. Then the land will yield its harvest, and God, our God, will bless us. God will bless us, and all the ends of the earth will fear him. Why must we praise him? That he may make his ways known to us. You know what happens when we praise God? Is that the presence of God comes down. Praise the Lord. I tell people it is better to praise God more to praise him than to pray. Because when you praise God, God comes down. In most of our prayers, we don't see God. Praise the Lord. But there is no way you will praise God and God will not come down. There is no way. For God, the Bible tells us in the book of Psalm 22 and verse 3, it says God dwells in the praises of his people. So where does he live? In our praises. Where does he live? In our praises. You want God to live in your home, then begin to praise him at home. You want him to live in your business, begin to praise him in that business. Anywhere you want God to come down, begin to sing his praises. Begin to worship him. You can't worship God with all your heart and you will not find him. He will come down. Because that is his food. Worship is God's food. He lives in praises. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And that's one thing we all need to know and we must key into. That we may know and that we may also key into. That God dwells in the praises of his people. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. Then how does God visit us? He also, when we say we are waiting, I am awaiting for the visitation of the Lord. It is not when I begin to pray that he visits me. In the book of Psalm 100, verses 1 to 4, he said, I will enter into his gates with what? With thanksgiving. I will enter into his court with what? With praises. So what do we use to knock his door to come down? It is not your complaint. Because what do we do in prayer? We complain. We grumble. That's what we do in prayer. We cry. It's not our tears that will make it to come down. It is our worship. Our praise. Our worship. Our praise. So you can't praise God until you have joy in you. There are people who are praising God without joy. You think you are praising God. God, you can't praise God without joy. Because when there is no joy in you, you cannot even praise. As you are praising and you are dancing and people are dancing, maybe you are forcing yourself to praise. And you are saying, well, you see, I'm just doing it. I don't want people to ask me what happened. Then you are not praising. Until you know how to praise him, you can never carry his presence. And I know there are people here who want to continually carry the presence of God. You know what it means to carry the presence of God? That's all we need. To continue to carry his presence. For him to visit you in the morning, visit you in the afternoon, visit you at night. It's 100%, 24/7 beside you. Always going out with you. Always coming in with you. Then tell him which arrow of the enemy will hit you. That arrow must hit God first. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So every time people praise God, God reveals himself to us every time we praise him. Every time we praise him. Why? Because he lives in the praise. He's in that place as you are praising him. And he feeds on our worship. He feeds. So when you have not worshipped him in a day, then you know that you have denied God something and you are owing him. In the book of Psalm 149, he said, we owe God our thanksgiving. We owe him praise. So every day, you are a debtor of praise and worship. A debtor. Maybe some of us are still owing him for today. Maybe some of us are going here for the one of yesterday. But I believe that at the end of this service, I told the choir, I said, please be ready to make us dance today. Because every sickness and every sorrow will disappear as we worship the Lord today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The one we have done is not enough yet. Not enough at all. When God visits you, He makes His ways known to you. That's what we saw in that passage. Verse 2 of Psalm 67. When He visits, we say that your ways may be known on the earth. When He visits you, He makes His ways known unto you. And when He makes His ways known unto you, that means that you can never be stranded in life. Somebody tell yourself, I will never be stranded in life.
I will never be stranded.
In the name of Jesus. Because now I know what to do. At every crossroad, in life, when things are so tough and you don't know what to do, go into praise and worship. Not prayer, because you are prayed. That's not what they will say, let us pray. You say, which prayer I won't pray again? I don't pray since. I did pray. For people will tell you, say, see, I did pray. And if, you know, maybe it is not prayer you need any longer. You need to begin to worship Him. You need to bring down His presence. Praise the Lord. Because we keep praying and praying and praying and praying, and as if nothing is happening, then it shows that there is something missing. Praise is missing in your life. And you are entering into it today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Amen. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs, it says, enjoy.